Locks. This is the Puget.
Puget, this is the Locks.
We are inbound, requesting an upstream lockage. Ready for you, Puget. Come on in. Roger, Locks.
Welcome to the Hiram M. Chittenden Locks, the westernmost stop along the 8-mile Lake Washington Ship Canal. More than 75,000 commercial and recreational vessels navigate the locks each year as they make their way between the freshwater of Lake Washington, Lake Union, Salmon Bay, and the saltwater of Puget Sound.
The locks have been in continuous operation since they opened August 3, 1916. The locks operate 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, year-round.
The activity at the locks attracts more than 1.5 million visitors each year, making it the third most visited site in Seattle. Local residents and their out-of-town guests mix with international travelers from countries throughout the world.
You never know what you'll see when you come to the locks. Each visit will be a new adventure.
Salmon Bay and Lakes Washington and Union had a long and colorful history before the Lake Washington Ship Canal was even built.
Glacial advance and retreat formed the Puget Sound region, creating the freshwater lakes Union and Washington and the saltwater inlet of Puget Sound called Salmon Bay. These separate bodies of water were to become the connecting link of commerce for the Seattle area. This is a story of the Lake Washington Ship Canal, which has helped to make Seattle a growing, thriving community.
Settlement of Seattle occurred in the 1850s. Development was compressed into the narrow corridor between Puget Sound and Lake Washington. Most of the settlers lived west of the lake, and the resources of timber and coal lay to the east. These materials were transported by horse-driven wagons and rail due to the lack of an east-west waterway route. Coal had to be transferred 11 times on its way from the mines to the bunkers at the foot of Seattle's Pike Street.
On July 4, 1854, at a picnic on the shores of Lake Union, pioneer Thomas Mercer voiced the idea of building a canal from Lake Washington through Lake Union and Salmon Bay to Puget Sound. It was only a matter of time before Mercer's idea became reality.
Despite the efforts of the leaders of Seattle and determined individuals like Harvey Pike, who tried to dig the canal single-handedly, all that existed in 1886 was a shallow, narrow cut, suitable for floating logs from Lake Washington to Lake Union.
In 1890, Congress authorized the Corps of Engineers to conduct a survey for a suitable ship canal route. Five routes were investigated. However, controversy over site selection stalled the project until Major Hiram M. Chittenden became Seattle District Engineer in 1906. He advocated a route through Salmon Bay with a single set of locks at the west end of the bay, while others wanted one lock at Montlake and one at Salmon Bay.
Chittenden's plan for a double concrete lock was approved in 1910, and more than $2.25 million were authorized for the project. Construction on the locks, dam, canal, and fish ladder began in 1911. The federal government, Washington State, and King County each provided funding for the work, which ultimately cost about $3.5 million.
5 years and 4 million cubic yards of dirt later, the Lake Washington Ship Canal was completed, 63 years after Thomas Mercer first voiced the idea. The skills of the Army Corps of Engineers brought the canal to life. The Corps was assigned to survey, design, and supervise the construction of the locks and to oversee the project once construction was finished. On July 4, 1917, thousands flocked to the locks to celebrate the official dedication.
What was once a distant vision is now a thriving canal system providing efficient navigation for the more than 2 million tons of cargo and more than 75,000 vessels that travel through the locks each year. Upon its dedication, the locks was the largest navigation structure in North America. Barges with cargo bound for Alaska, commercial crab and fish boats heading out to sea, tandem tows piled high with sand and gravel, and log rafts destined for lumber mills all move through the locks. Today, more vessels transit the Hiram M. Chittenden locks than any other lock in the United States. Commercial vessels have numbered about 20,000 annually since the locks opened. Recreational traffic, on the other hand, has increased 80% over time. During the busy summer months, more than 100 pleasure boats can pack into the large lock chamber and make the lockage together.
As a visitor, you can get an exceptional up-close view of the locks and boats as you walk along the gates and walls of the lock chambers. Each lock operates independently, which keeps vessel traffic moving smoothly. The small lock can hold boats as large as 120 feet long and 26 feet wide. The large lock can handle vessels as long as 760 feet and as wide as 78 feet. Water levels in the locks are raised and lowered using the power of gravity. No pumps are used. Fresh water flows into and out of the lock chambers through culverts, which are opened and closed by motorized control valve.
Each lock chamber is dewatered annually to conduct inspections, make repairs, and perform preventative maintenance. These pump outs are scheduled in November for the large lock and March for the small lock. If you visit during one of these pump outs, you'll get a unique perspective of the size of each lock chamber.
On the south side of the small lock is a spillway dam with tater gates used to regulate the water level of the canal and lakes. The gates are operated year-round to maintain the lake level within a 2-foot range of 20 to 22 feet above sea level. The lake levels are critical for floating bridges, mooring facilities, and vessel clearance under bridges. Lower water levels in the winter reduce the potential of storm damage caused by flooding. Higher water levels in the summer accommodate recreation and provide water storage in case of drought conditions. Water flowing into Lake Washington provides Seattle's municipal and industrial water supply and are vital for fish survival.
South of the spillway dam is the fish ladder, which was originally constructed in 1916 to allow migratory salmon to pass around the locks and dam. This ladder is one of only three fish ladders in the United States that is located where salt and fresh water converge. The Corps rebuilt the ladder in 1976 by increasing the flow of attraction water and adding additional steps. Windows in the fish ladder viewing gallery give you a close-up view of the fish as they return to spawn in the waters of Lake Washington and its tributaries.
Each year, more than 500,000 salmon pass through the fish ladder and locks. From November through May, you might glimpse the rare and beautiful steelhead as it returns to spawn. In summer, visitors cheer the returning sockeye, chinook, and coho as they climb the ladder. Each April, a smolt slide is installed in one of the spillway gates to provide juvenile salmon with another out-migration route. Exhibits in the gallery explain the life cycle, migration periods, and evolving egg stages of the salmon.
As you leave the visitor center, you are surrounded by the 7-acre Carl S. English Jr. Botanical Garden. which contains more than 500 species and 1,500 varieties of trees, shrubs, and flowers from around the world. Japanese maples with flaming red leaves, rhododendrons, palm trees from China, mountain hemlocks from the Pacific Northwest, Mexican pines, and Korean dogwoods are just a few of the plants you can see in the garden. Many of their seeds were gathered by Carl English, the core botanist who oversaw the development and care of the garden for more than 40 years. The garden is most magnificent in the spring when the rhododendrons, magnolias, flowering cherries, and crabapples are in bloom. During the summer months, you'll witness a brilliant, vivid display of color in our rose, fuchsia, and perennial beds. An outstanding collection of oaks, beautiful dawn redwoods, and mature palm trees can be enjoyed all year round. We invite you to stroll through the garden and discover why English described it as a joyous sight to see and a garden worthy of serious study.
Looking east from the locks, the Ship Canal stretches to Lake Washington through the man-made cuts at Fremont and Montlake. Fremont Cut is bordered by the Burt Gilman Multi-Use Trail on the north and the South Ship Canal Multi-Use Trail on the south. Joggers, picnickers, and sightseers are frequent visitors to this area. Benches and overlooks provide places to rest and enjoy the area.
Originally only a 6-foot-wide log flume, Montlake Cut is now a favorite getaway for many Seattle residents. Along the south side of the cut, visitors enjoy the Montlake National Scenic Waterside Trail. This scenic trail connects the University of Washington's Arboretum Trail with the city's West Montlake Park on Lake Union. Along the trail are a variety of plants and observation decks. Designed by the Corps' engineers, landscape architects, and the Seattle Garden Club, the trail was designated as a National Scenic Waterside Trail in 1971.
The Lake Washington Ship Canal and Hiram M. Chittenden Locks have become part of Seattle's daily life. Day or night, the activity never stops. The changing scene invites exploration. Boaters making their way back to port, powerful tugs heading to far-off places, salmon swimming up the steps of the fish ladder, and the quiet beauty of the garden. All this is yours to enjoy today and for generations to come. We hope this and every visit you make to the Hiram M. Chittenden Locks is a pleasant and memorable one.